This time around, I want to actually talk about editors as a soft skill. And I want to talk about Visual Studio Code first. So I opened up a project in Rust, which actually contains the logic for this subscribe animation in ASCII art. And as you can see, I'm using VS Code. It's my favorite text editor, and I've learned to use it quite well. I switch my tabs with option command left and right, just like in browsers, right? I'm quite happy to use this approach because I do a lot of presentations at work, and mouse is not always working with presentation applications such as Microsoft Teams. So I kind of had to adopt this habit, right? And it's working in my VS Code setup, all right? I also have learned for my presentations to use Command B to show more of the code and not get distracted with the thing over here with file tree. So that's quite nice. as VS Code adapt, I quite frequently use Command B to, browse my files. I can search for a specific name, README. So yeah, it gives me just that. So with many years of experience with that, I'm using more and more commands. I sometimes, well, quite a lot actually, use go-tos for a specific line. For example, if I need to go to line 92, where some interesting stuff happens, Command G will give me the prompt to enter the number, and here I am at 93, right? So quite easy. But the issue is VS Code right now is, for me, I am on a Mac, and it's quite a nice computer, but still, with even easier projects like this, where there's just one file, it kind of starts to drain power on my computer quite a lot. And it quite literally consumes a lot of memory. So if this had been a larger project, I would see more and more helpers of different kinds to just host my my code. So there's something that eats up 150 megabytes over here. There's some plugin helpers, GPU helper to render out a bunch of CSS in Electron-based application, which is VS Code, and this is quite frustrating for me. And I have noticed that in JavaScript applications, it's quite, with more and more packages as you use them in your code, inside VS Code, this tends to grow into like dozens of more and more helpers. And my battery drains quite a lot. You could have seen that happen when I was doing my previous sessions, when I was writing in some JavaScript. So this is quite a lot and seems unnecessary. I have been playing with Vim and Vim-like editors like Doom Emacs, which was quite cool, but there was more heavy configurations that I had to do. Yeah, this is about VS Code interactions, not much, but still. So Doom Emacs was great, but there was some configuration issues that my Mac had with after update, and I played around with Space Vim and things like that, which also had some issues with Python 3. But with Helix editor, and you might have seen me have it open over here. I don't care if it's written in Rust, it's not that important. But I do find it quite similar to VS Code at this moment. I mean, as soon as you open it, it's prompting you to show whatever you want. So yeah, I've decided to see the source code for this animation again. I'm still able to use my trackpad to scroll the code. Since I'm used to navigating through the code a bit in VS Code with command prompts, I also have learned to do that in a Vim-like infrastructure. So G for go, and where was I going to go? Yeah, let's go to line number 3 and press G again. So I'm at line 3, G, 93 back then in VS Code, and G again. I'm at 93 line again. There's some navigation coolness, like pressing W for word, going one word further, or B for one word backward. It's not that complicating to go to next line by pressing O, which is quite cool. Escape to normal navigation mode and pressing U to undo the changes. Quite cool. What about that switching between open tabs? It's kind of slow. Yeah. Well, if I open up more things in Helix. So pressing space, right? There's like a cool helper, a file picker. What do I want to open? A README. Cool. So a README, it just shows me what I want to see. V down, delete. So there's all kinds of coolness that you can kind of do, right? If I want to switch to another tab or a buffer in this case, well, just look at the helper space. There's B for buffer picker. Yeah, go to main. Or what was that thing? If I don't know what I want to do, I can still press space and just see command palette. I mean, not that different from here, command P, right? All right, question tab, next buffer. Go to next buffer, so buffer next, so this is a column. I guess there's an alias for next buffer, probably buffer N, BN, exactly, alias BN. We'll just give me this, BN, no, colon BN. So this is quite fast, actually. What is VS Code missing, in my opinion, is just proper navigation between paragraphs. I mean, once you're here, right, it is quite obvious you can jump from here to this because it's the next paragraph, the next point of interest. Well, closing square bracket and see the description. Next function or paragraph, in my case, which is what I want. So P, this is the next paragraph, next paragraph, next paragraph, opening bracket to go back. Well, there's another paragraph back that I want to go to, or maybe a previous function. I mean, it's so freaking fast. And the thing is, I'm not Primogen or TJ Dev or whatever those Vim users are. There's a reason why this is important for me. So, as I was saying previously, for some reason on a Mac, VS Code just kind of sucks. It's consuming so much energy and it's lagging. It's just it's just absurd. I mean, look at the things that code is trying to run all the time. Whereas look at Helix, 8.5 megabytes. Well, this is not that much. Well, what about Rust code analyzer? Well, it does take 170 megabyte. There's another instance, 3.2. Jesus, this is not that much. I mean, for code helper to work. By the way, I'm able to use a function left and right just in normal code editor. It's not Vim specific stuff. I can jump between words. I still use like all the goodness of normal editors. It's really cool to like, if I want to rename a symbol, rename a variable pawn, I'm at it, right? I just press R and it gives me right down below here. I don't want to call my variable pawn. I want it to be a sprite, because I am showing a sprite, literally sprite. And look at here, after I press the enter, this pawn here will change to sprite. Cool. All the goodness I have in VS Code, I can use it just right here. I can select stuff. I guess I will not be able to copy paste stuff, but I mean, this is quite cool. Let's go here and let's open another file, for example, cargo log. This is great. As far as configuration stuff goes, you know, of course, VS Code is easier in regards to installing plugins. I mean, you just search for Python, you get description, but well, that is all fine and good. Oh man, my CPU is just spiking right now. What is it doing? Yeah, it's consuming a lot. Actually, let's close it up. Close. And let's see this slowly go away. The helpers are going away. What is this shit? Yeah, it's gone. I just freed up my CPU and the memory consumption. You kind of see it drop over here. Cool. As for Helix, well, in order to install my Rust helper, yeah, you kind of have to go to configs and edit this stuff. I went to configs, Helix, languages, TAML, and added this. Is this terrible? Well, it's kind of unusual to do it like this, but what do we do in other languages, for example? Well, this is my small package.json for a simple React app. I mean, sometimes you just go and add your dependencies right in the JSON, and you do npm install and it just runs. Well, this kind of is nothing different from what we do at our day jobs anyway, right? Why would I not choose going into configuration file and edit it and just be fluent in other configurations a bit, right? It will not hurt, at least. What other stuff I wanted to show? Well, I guess that's it. So the Rust analyzer that I had, it really, memory consumption and the CPU, so the VS Code is not running Rust. The Rust analyzer, okay, it helps to do things like, let's go to some here stuff. What do I want to do? Go to next paragraph. what cells in there. So the update rate. If I wanted to go to definition, you just press G and there's like a helper. Yeah, go to definition. Yeah, you're back in here. Well, go definition of this. You're already in here. This is actually quite profound for me. And yeah, I guess if I want to go to definition of this, whoops, go to definition, it shows me this stuff. It's almost the same if I was using plain old. VS Code. So if I go again to my line 93, did I press it? Oh, yeah, presentation time. So there's a bunch of helpers, right? I mean, there's like extensive stuff that I get from VS Code anyway, right? So pick your battles. I mean, for me it's important so that my computer doesn't sound like a vacuum cleaner when I work with it. And yeah, it did take some time to be this bad even. I mean, I'm quite good with navigation already, but it takes some time. But why would I be in software industry if things were easy, right? Anyway, that's my rant. This is a nice soft skill for me to jump through different distributions of Vim, and I played with Emacs, the vanilla one. It's terrible. Doom Emacs was great. But yeah, Helix for now is probably the closest one to VS Code, where you don't have to download additional configurations for your editor to kind of resemble VS Code. This is already VS Code-ish, like you're not pressing Command P, you're pressing space for main stuff, you choose what you want to do, jump through buffers, all right, space F, select a file, cannot find your file, well, search for it, kind of want to do more and don't find what you want to do here, press question mark, type in like in VS Code with Command P, next whatever, next buffer, step to next whatever, config. Is there stuff to do with the config? Yes, there's stuff to do with the config. The only thing I did with my config was I decided the theme one dark, because Helix has this acid-looking purple whatever scheme in their default implementation. But this looks more like VS Code for me. Since my neighbors decided to do some renovation, I'm gonna end it here right now. And this rant didn't consume too much of memory for me, because I wasn't using VS Code. Not memory, battery. The battery is still fine. Alright, I hope this rant was okay for you. I know it was bad. And don't forget to subscribe.